The 2020 fire year began with the U.S. assisting Australia. Through a cooperative agreement with Australia, the United States deployed a total of 362 fire suppression specialists from December 2019 through March of 2020, when the last group returned to the U.S. Nationally, the number of fires and total acreage burned in 2020 were well over the number of fires and total acreage burned in 2019. A large proportion of the burned acreage occurred in California, accounting for 38% of the nation's total burned acres. The nation spent 44 days at the highest level of wildfire preparedness. A record 32,727 firefighters were deployed on a single day in late summer to support firefighting efforts. 2020 resulted in 15 wildland fire-related fatalities, six more than 2019. These fatalities included 9 aviation-related, 4 medical, and 2 entrapments. Aviation fatalities included 3 Americans who died in an air tanker crash in Australia on January 22nd. Civilian lives were lost in wildfires, particularly in California and the Northwest. Fast-moving, large wildfire incidents affected thousands of homes and displaced homeowners. Most of these structures were in California and Oregon. This is well above the annual average. 2020 saw the first reported million-acre wildfire incident, the August Complex in Northern California. Numerous large fires resulting in fatalities and significant property losses occurred in Oregon, Washington, California, and Colorado. Colorado experienced the 3 largest wildfires in the state's history: Cameron Peak, East Troublesome, and Pine Gulch. An unusually extended fire season occurred in the Southwest due to a late monsoon. By mid-August, wildland firefighting resources were stretched thin. International agreements facilitated support from Canada and Mexico. Additionally, federal and state firefighting efforts were aided by state National Guard and active duty military deployed to wildfires in California and throughout the West. Overall, the 2020 fire year reinforced what many wildland fire agencies have experienced for more than 20 years. Wildland fire activity starts earlier in the spring, lasts longer into the fall, and involves more intense, difficult-to-control fires.
So I think it's important to start off with how well we did last year addressing COVID-19 and how everyone pulled together and how much work was done. Some of the biggest accomplishments from last year were the way that we engineered distance within fire camp. We saw less sick people in camp. We fed people differently. We used spike camps more. We were able to pull on expertise by using virtual positions that we probably couldn't have done before. I think a lot of the virtual capacity that was built last year will continue to be built, and we'll continue to perfect that because we saw the value in that moving forward, even beyond COVID. We also developed this informal COVID lead position, and that became crucial for incident management teams to take the burden of COVID off of the incident and allow the incident management teams to focus on fighting fire. There are a few key pieces that are new for this year that we want everyone to be aware of. One is getting a better understanding out there about the module as one concept. The focus on module as one this year is really about being able to insulate your module, your crew, and really stick together and ensure people that come into that module are healthy and that you stick together and you don't go outside of that module or you limit any outside exposure. And as we all know, that's very hard to do. It can be done, but we just want people to know what the limitations are with module as one. The other takeaway from that is that module as one cannot be used with IMT members. IMT members often travel from various locations, are not able to quarantine ahead of assignment, and often interact with the public. And so they just can't achieve that true module as one as defined. So that's a big change for this year that we need to make sure people understand. The other big change for this year is we have a federal mandate that requires face coverings in the workplace. The bottom line there is that everyone will wear face coverings at all times when they can't maintain 6 feet of distance unless they're engaged in arduous activity. And probably the biggest change, a component that we did not have last year, was the development of the COVID-19 vaccine. There are two vaccines that are 95% effective, and this is the most important way that you can help protect yourself and others from COVID-19. And so the medical and public health advisory team is recommending that all fire personnel get vaccinated before they go out this year. Even with the vaccine, there are a lot of questions out there on whether or not folks will continue to have to wear their face mask or practice the mitigations that have been put in place. And the answer to that is yes. Even with the vaccine, there's still a federal mandate for face coverings, and these mitigations that have been put in place are still very important. The vaccine is just another layer of protection, and the more layers you have of protection, the more effective they are. And that's the goal that we're trying to reach this year with vaccine and all of the mitigation, so that we can put an end to the spread of COVID-19 within our wildland fire community. Another major takeaway from last year is that information with COVID changes rapidly. So it's important that everyone stays in tune with the NWCG coronavirus webpage, along with the Centers for Disease Control webpage, to ensure that they have the most up-to-date information. My advice for this year is to stay positive and be flexible and do everything that you can do to protect yourself and help protect others. And that includes being vaccinated, taking the mitigations seriously, and doing your part.
We are all students of fire. We study, observe, and practice to become experts on fire behavior, suppression tactics, and new technology on our local unit, in our geographic area, and across our country. But even the best students are lost without teachers. At the Wildland Fire Lessons Learned Center, experts collect, refine, and distribute data for the benefit of all wildland firefighters. The LLC website is a single point source where firefighters can both seek and share knowledge to improve safe work performance and expand operational learning. You may be familiar with some of their products. Others may be new to you. Incident reviews, rapid lesson sharing, connected community forums, newsletters, blogs, and even podcasts. LLC publishes an annual incident review summary. This product collects lessons from the previous fire year and condenses them into manageable chunks of information paired with actionable follow-up exercises. Just because your shaps are on does not mean your legs are protected. Your shaps need to be snug. 2020 is the third year in a row where a saw cut a firefighter when loose shaps were pulled aside by a spinning chain. Do you always tighten leg straps so your shaps are snug? Do you drill on how to deal with a chainsaw cut? If not, take action. In 2020, the Lessons Learned Center recorded 6 incidents where vehicles caught fire. 4 incidents occurred during active fire operations. A tractor caught fire on a fuels reduction project. An engine burned while parked in a bay. Do you check and spray down your parking area in the black? Do you inspect your AED during preventative maintenance checks? Do you regularly clear combustible debris from hard-to-reach spaces on your rig? If not, take action. The Lessons Learned Center periodically releases infographics to rapidly share lessons with the field. These infographics are a visual reminder of significant incidents and trends, lessons we can learn, and actions we must take to prevent becoming a statistic. Study them, print them out, hang them in your ready room as a daily reminder. Aggressive initial attack and a surge in firefighting aircraft helped ensure the safety of firefighters and the public while reducing wildfire size and intensity in 2020. While the COVID-19 pandemic continues to challenge fire suppression and preparedness activities, wildland fire agencies work together to implement tactics, guidance, and other regulations to greatly reduce virus spread potential among employees. As we enter another potentially active fire year, it is up to you to stay safe, stay informed, and look out for each other.